Well, good day to you all. Over the course of the past year, I've enjoyed watching many videos of different makers and repairers making and repairing. And I thought I would try to do a series of videos where I would restore this piece. The story behind this piece, I received it from a customer who sent it overseas to have it restored and in working condition. And the watchmaker, where he sent it, took it all apart and then died, passed away. And this piece came to me in Ziploc baggies. Matter of fact, here are some of them right here. The problem with this is that it is missing numerous parts. Not all the parts were sent back once the watchmaker passed away. And being a family piece, I'm being asked to restore this, and including making the parts that are missing in it. This is quite a complicated piece. You can see the many the numbers around the dial. First off, this piece I suspect is from the 1790s or thereabouts. French in origin, Paris, made in Paris. I'll take the movement out in a little bit and show you. It's a French verged fusee. It has around the, it has, of course, the center hand that's still on there is belongs to the alarm mechanism. Of course, it has the standard time train. It also has a calendar mechanism around the end, and then rather early version of a repeater out through this tube in the bottom. Comes a chain with a little bob on it that you pull, and it has a quarter repeater on the inside. Like I said, it's missing a number of parts, including five gear assemblies. As many of you know, a gear is the assembly is not just one piece, it's actually a steel pinion and a brass gear. So there's actually two pieces for every gear that's missing and that need to be made. Two pieces that need to be made. So take this out here and I'll show you. Some of the pieces are pretty obvious. Obvious in that they're missing. Other pieces are pretty deep in the mechanism. I've already taken the pin out that holds this together. But, you know, without the scale of my hands, this looks like almost any other French or Swiss verge fusee. Very similar styling. Matter of fact, when the customer first sent pictures to me, I thought it was just your standard pocket watch, and got it here, and obviously it's significantly larger. It's actually a piece that will hang on the wall from a hook. So, Ageron, or I don't know the French pronunciation of this, but made in Paris, France. And couple things that you can note immediately from the back. Let me find something to point with. These two points here and here are missing the part that comes out of it. And if we look in through the side, we'll see why, because they're completely missing. So this portion right here is for the repeating mechanism, I believe. Nope, that's the alarm mechanism, and the repeating mechanism is the one over here. So here's one hammer, and here's the other hammer. And so this part right here is the end of a series of the gear train for the repeating mechanism. And if you could, you can't really see on the video, but all of these pivot holes here are missing what is in there, missing the gears to the repeating mechanism. We just have the main gear. You can see over here the main spring for the repeating mechanism, which is beautifully, the barrel is beautifully engraved. Here's the alarm mechanism, main spring, and the star wheel. You can't see it. There's a little bit of rust on that star wheel. But then the hammer for the alarm mechanism is completely missing, as well as I suspect the on-off or the regulator is missing. In the time train, and here again it's awful dark in there and you aren't going to be able to see it, but the contrite wheel is actually completely missing. And so we've got the alarm hammer, four gears in the repeating chain train that's missing, the regulator for the repeating, regulate the speed of the repeater, the contrite wheel, that all need to be fabricated and made. And you'll notice that the chain is not in there. I do have the chain, the fusee chain. And so I thought I would just take and very methodically go through this and see if we can't restore it. That's the desire of the customer. I'm going to go about it in a very slow procedure, slow methodical way. Since the time train is only missing one gear, I'm going to start with getting the time mechanism and making the contrite wheel first. I think it's called the contrite wheel. Some of you that probably know better than I do, and then we'll move on to the alarm, and lastly we'll finish up with the repeating mechanism. Here's some of the baggies that I received. The original hairspring is there, and here's parts and pieces to the repeating mechanism, including the bob and the chain that comes out this post. Here's the hour and minute and calendar hand, and then here's the fusee chain. But it's going to be my attempt, and it's not going to be one video, it's going to be several videos if I'm successful in doing this, in restoring this piece. And it's going to be a little bit more difficult than doing it without a camera in front of me, so be patient with me. Also, I am not a professional by any means when it comes to videography. I'm just going to be trying to do this through a smartphone camera, and we'll see how it goes. Hopefully you can find this informative, entertaining, and who knows what else. So I hope you enjoy. I just thought I would start off with this introductory video, and we'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.